Welcome to a lesson on even and odd trigonometric identities. The goal of the video is to state and illustrate the even and odd trig identities. Let's start by talking about even functions. Even functions are symmetrical across the y-axis. Here are two functions that are even. If we were to fold these two functions across the y-axis, the right half would match up perfectly with the left half. Meaning if we folded this across the y-axis, this half here would fall directly on this half here. Another way to think of it is that every point on the right side of this function, let's say this point here, has a mirror image on the left side, this point right here. So we can say this function is a mirror image across the line y equals x. And the same is true for the graph of y equals cosine theta. If we were to fold this graph across the y-axis, it would match up perfectly with the other half. This half here would match up perfectly with this half here. More specifically, if we take a look at this function here, f of 2 is equal to 2. If we change the sign of the x-coordinate, let's say we want f of negative 2, notice that f of negative 2 is also equal to positive 2. So if the function is even, if we change the sign of the x-coordinate, the y-coordinate, or the function value, remains the same. To generalize this, we say f of x is equal to f of negative x if the function is even. For the trig function, if we consider x equals pi over 2, this point here, we know f of pi over 2 is equal to 0. And f of negative pi over 2 is also equal to 0. So here are the even trig identities. Cosine of negative theta is equal to cosine theta, and the same is true for the reciprocal function secant theta. And again, you can see graphically that these are symmetrical across the y-axis. Now let's talk about odd functions. Odd functions are symmetrical about the origin, which means they have rotational symmetry about the origin, which means if we rotate this 180 degrees about the origin, the function would look exactly the same. This blue half and this green half would just switch places if we rotated this 180 degrees in either direction about the origin. And the same is true for the graph of y equals sine theta. If we rotate this about the origin 180 degrees, this blue half and this green half would just switch places. So let's see what happens when we consider function values on odd functions. Notice in this graph, f of 2 is equal to positive 2. But f of negative 2, if we switch the sign of the x-coordinate, notice how the y-coordinate also switches signs. F of negative 2 is equal to negative 2. So to state this relationship in general, we say that f of x is equal to the opposite of f of negative x. Or if we multiply both of these by negative 1 and then flip it around, we could say that f of negative x is equal to the opposite of f of x. Meaning if the function is odd and we change the sign of the x-coordinates, the y-coordinates, or the function values, will be the opposite sign. For the trig function, notice that f of pi over 2 is equal to 1, and f of negative pi over 2 is equal to negative 1. So let's take a look at the odd trig identities. Here they are for sine and cosecant, because these are odd functions. And the same is true for tangent and cotangent. Tangent and cotangent are odd functions, therefore they have rotational symmetry about the origin. And here's a summary of those identities. Let's take a look at some examples. First example, if sine x is equal to 0.75, then sine of negative x is going to be equal to negative 0.75. The sine function is an odd function, so if we change the sign of the x-coordinates, the function values will be the opposite sign. But the cosine function is an even function, so if we change the sign of the x-coordinates on the sine function, the function values stay the same. So if cosine x equals 0.2, then cosine negative x is also equal to 0.2. The tangent function is an odd function, so if tangent x equals 5.3, then tangent negative x is equal to negative 5.3. In our last example, the secant function is an even function. If secant negative x is equal to 2.9, then secant x is equal to 2.9 as well. I hope you found these explanations helpful. Thank you for watching.